Rated 13. Recommended for family viewing.
A very beautiful morning and another beautiful day to be celebrated in the world as far as the calendar is concerned. That is 2020. Happy New Year, ladies and gentlemen, and of course a welcome back from that huge festive season. I definitely believe that you came up a changed person as far as your different goals are concerned, as far as your different achievements are concerned come this year 2020. My name is Derek Ainedash, and of course I would like to use this opportunity to actually say happy 2020. Like people are calling it all over social media, 2020 is definitely going to be a year where you walk up with success. And for us down here at Urban Television, we are telling you that we are continuing to serve you and giving you all the information that you definitely need courtesy of Urban Today. Now, today on the show, we'll be, of course, looking into a little bit of New Year banter that, of course, will be shared amongst the three of us. Yes, the trio is in studio. And then, of course, away from that, we'll also be looking at some interesting but sad conversations that have been happening on social media. We're talking about rape accusations, and we're trying to find out what exactly is happening with our dear millennials. And of course, we will not let that topic go without talking about consent, which is something that is very key. Now, at that point in time, I would like to remind you that we are active on social media, and all you need to do is very simple. We need you to be part of this conversation, especially on our Kachai, where we're talking about rape accusations that have made another interesting headline in the country as far as consent is concerned. Now, we understand that, of course, when we talk about rape, usually most of these cases, they usually originate from, you know, drinking, having a beer, having a couple of, you know, alcoholic drinks. So we are asking you, should consent be before the bottle or after the bottle? Head over to our social media pages and be able to get in touch with us regarding that feedback that will weigh in, of course, as the show goes on. Our Facebook page hasn't changed despite the year changing to 2020. It is still Urban Television, and Twitter, it is at Urban TV Uganda. Use the hashtag Urban Today. You can tag me personally at Ainedash, and of course, don't forgetting the rest of the members that you'll be seeing later on. And of course, away from that, we'll be looking into the 195 kilometer walk that has been started by His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni. We'll be giving you more details coming in away from that. And later on, we'll be taking you to Tony Bujingo, who apparently has launched a new church. All that and much more right here on the show. But for now, allow me to introduce to you the one and only amazing crew that usually is going to walk this road with me up to 2020 end of year. Good morning to you, Willis.
Good morning.
How are you doing?
First, I want to look at you straight.
Why
in
is
face.
He like?
Yeah.
Should we all like?
It's the beginning of the decade.
You're yeah. looking people
I need
straight
to look
in the
at
eye.
You in the eye. Okay. Mm-hmm. Then probably half the decade, I'm like, Gundi Okuze, or what to fit up.
I don't know why are we even acting like it's normal. We have to let the fans bring gifts. Willis is a brand new daddy.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Let's take a minute. I mean, we always.
Congratulations!
Yeah. Yeah. He is how old is our little one now?
10 days.
10 days.
10 days. Christmas.
Yeah, he was born.
I'll never forget that day, man.
He was born on
how
Christmas.
How was it?
You can forget 12th of December, whatever, but you can't forget Christmas.
How was it? How was it? The whole experience for you?
Man, when you hear that first noise. Uh-huh. That guy, you're like, okay.
Wait, they are here.
Okay, atuse, katikatulabe. Aina mikono hivi, esatu. Aina vigera, aina maso. Niamkweza, uchinota niko kevila, no kevila, no kevila. No tusako, no zako. Ninaenga bambi mami achaka, bawali ino gambe, katineka, tusabori na yako meo.
It was so confusing.
Yeah, it's Well, for people like me, I'm a strong person.
Lol.
You're not scared at
anything. No, I bet you cried.
I've practiced this for 9 months. I've practiced that moment for 9 months. So it's going to go either one of the few ways I've done. It's not going to go any other way. So I've practiced that time. I know how it's going to go. So I'm just there, you know. There's that inch of that
How
edge.
Does it feel to have a newborn baby in the house? Everything is silent. Is people it? Walk on tiptoes.
No, not.
Not to wake the baby
no,
up.
No, it's not silent. Sleepless nights.
Mm. Oh, yeah.
This kind of thing feels like they are going to control everyone.
Oh, yeah, they're tired.
When they want to eat, everyone has to stop so they breastfeed. When they want to sleep, everyone has to sort of, you know,
tip-toe.
Sneak around. When it's...
So, the house doesn't have to be silent because I believe now I'm one of a bit more silent house. You says, my wife says, we're to avoid these things. Stereotyping is still happening.
I just want to take a minute. Congratulations to you. And most especially, congratulations to you, D. You done did it. 9 months hasn't been easy, has it?
9 months hasn't been an easy.
Crazy.
It hasn't been an easy month.
Okay.
Easy time. Yeah. And, you know, congratulations to her. She pulled through. It was not easy.
At all.
The doctor says, kakati tugenatwale in a direction, and you're like, Jesus Christ.
We didn't plan on this.
How do we handle this? But, you know, the guys at TM are, you know, very professional people. And they handled, you know, like they say, every second counts.
Yeah.
To them, every second of the way they were there. Katikola watch, katitura wansi, katitue, kashlo mpira. They were there all the way.
Which
so, you know,
beautiful.
It was, you know, fantastic. And thank you, guys.
Yay! 2020 started off on a good note. So that means we are no longer the threesome. We're not a duo, a trio. We are now a quadri.
Auntie
Katibamzali,
she's
too young.
Among very many babies who have seen two decades.
I know, right? The old decade and the new decade.
Like he was almost not seeing the other decade and said that.
I know.
So he lived the other decade for about 5 days.
Yeah, and then
he's five into this.
That's quite interesting.
It is.
Now, for those of you who have lived both decades, we'd like to say congratulations to you and, of course, for having made it to beautiful year 2020. I think for the first time in my life, I've had a whole different vibe as far as the new year is concerned. Everyone is talking positivity as far as, you know, 2020 is concerned.
Yes.
And I want to believe that this is going to be another year for everyone to look forward to, and definitely I hope it's not that hot January in people's
homes. Come on,
I'm hoping so.
It's already hot. What I want to appreciate about 2020, like you said, the vibe, the people have that, there's that energy. Everybody has moved into the year very happy and very positive. And I do hope we keep the positivity because like I always tell you, you attract what you give off.
That's right.
Some parts where positivity is not going to really help you, like if you're sitting at your house without a job, I'm sorry, you can't be positive for not paying rent.
Those are the people who have been, you know, spicing up the entire conversation of World War III. I don't know if you guys saw it on Twitter.
That's scary.
And everyone is, you know, wondering what's happening. Could this be the ending time?
People are just not taking hostages. If you see Donald Trump's tweet, he's just
he's
not taking hostages.
He is
you
running.
Mess around, you are coming for your cultural site, you are coming for you, your children's children.
Did you see the tweet? But though, it's really been a concerning conversation because I was watching some troops that were going off into war, and one of the guys was like, I know social media is having jokes with this, but for us who are going to the front line, for us who are going to this
country where we are not
wanted, needed, or accepted, it's different. My brothers and sisters are going to die at the front line. But then... there's a funny question I wanted to ask. As they were talking about World War III, some dimwit from England goes like, is World War III a possibility and will England be a part of it? I'm like, there is a reason why it's World War. Whether you like are a part of it or not,
somewhere it has to affect you at the end of the day,
But I don't think it's going to happen.
Of course, it's not going to happen,
but it's going to.
It is something that raised the dust.
The World War could be a Cold War. We're not going to see people getting guns and going to the war fronts and fighting. We're going to see, you know, countries and governments being hacked. We already saw what Russia did to the U.S.
True.
Apparently. So I think it's going to be
a lot of accusations.
Cold war. Yes.
If the U.S.
is fighting the Middle East, then, you know, Africa is going to suffer somewhere. You understand?
Always.
So that's how the world war is going. It's not going to be the U.S.
But when you read the different tweets, I was reading the tweets from the Prime Minister of Iran, and it is not just a Cold War that they're actually looking at. They were actually very infuriated.
Yeah.
Half of the government is saying, you know what, death to America. And I'm like, okay, America can
actually
do them, but me.
Iran came out to lose, you know, one of their big soldiers. It was called a major I think I've forgotten the other.
That's the one they took.
Yeah.
He's the one they took.
And they're blaming, you know, the US. Apparently, this guy was shot down in a flight and was doing a couple of tours. And, you know, Russia's coming out to side with Iran. And then the USA is coming out to say this. And then Donald Trump is going on Twitter. And, you know, he's saying all sorts of rubbish. There's an Iranian, I think, who tweeted. And then Donald Trump came out to say that, oh, I can't believe you have Wi-Fi in your camp. And in my head,
We need to understand that the war on the ground is different from the war in the cyber rooms and it's different from the war online. And I think people like Donald Trump have mastered the war online.
Yeah,
like, you're not going to just get documents, duplicate them and put them online and expect to win a war.
True.
You have to twist the words to tell the story differently.
Anger them.
Yeah, I've seen people criticizing him about, you know, we are coming to use the new armory that we have to shoot down your culture sites and what. And people are like, no, culture sites are against war rules and whatnot. But you see, he's throwing around a threat. He's fighting a war online.
Well, that is what is happening, of course, outside the borders of the country. Now, talking about wars inside the country, Uganda, to be precise. Now, apparently, Bobi Wine has been given permission to actually go ahead and carry out his consultation as far as the 2021 election is concerned. Now, talking about that war here in the country, we're seeing our very own President Nyino doing walks, and the opposition has come out to attribute the fact that this walk is actually inclined to him, you know, getting support as far as the forthcoming general election is concerned. We're seeing, you know, Chagulanyi himself coming through to do consultations. What do you make of this too?
I mean, what is there to make of it? This is what I told people. 2020 is here, but 2021 is fast approaching, and everyone needs to understand the sides will be taken. We will have to pledge an allegiance, whether you're going for yellow or for red. Now, when opposition comes out and says, oh, these walks that the president is having are not just the walks there to, what do you expect? There's a national election coming up. He is supposed to also campaign just like you are. Maybe if he's doing it in ways that are unconstitutional, I have no problem.
I don't think the president is campaigning. That is watering down a war that was fought for 5 years in the 1980s. I think this is a walk that we needed.
Okay.
You know, and I think it has come in late. There are very many people who are telling this story, these stories of the war in a different perspective. You understand? I could have a problem with calling it the Museveni trick, as people are calling it on Twitter. But you see, the work in the context of the content in the work is necessary. Lots of young people do not know what happened.
Exactly.
You understand? But we are so lucky that some of these people who were there when this happened or who participated are there. So I think that it is very unnationalistic for an opposition person to stand and say, no, you see, he's campaigning.
To make it
elections
political.
Are 1 year away. You know, Ugandans move on as fast as 2 weeks.
That's very true.
You understand?
Snap
so
of
we
a
need,
finger.
Yeah, we need this work so that young people could know what exactly happened.
To know about your history.
But one more last question I'd like to pose to both of you before we get into the details of the work. You know, according to His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, he believes that this walk is going to instill, you know, patriotism as far as, you know, the youth are concerned. Do you agree with him? Do you feel like this kind of walks would actually instill patriotism within Ugandans?
I think it will. If you look at, and I think it's not just the only walk. There are many other walks that we need to have. We need to have, there are people who fought from the East. They also walked. So we need to have those walks. So people need to participate. I saw young people who participated saying, we walked 38 kilometers. I am tired, but the old man is still walking. You understand?
Yeah.
So when someone begins to think like that, they are saying, okay, I think we were watering down this guy's contribution towards this.
Okay.
So I think that the walk is going to instill patriotism. I think we need it. And I think it shouldn't be about NRM or FDC or whatever. For example, the president in Bukedde just here saying, I will get the Kubesije, Boya Muonya, Monsiko. People have mistold this story. But
so
when
times.
You walk, you know, there are people out there who are there who will tell you, Charlie, wo ya iti da one one one.
Because he was actually his personal doctor.
Yes, he was his personal doctor. So some of these stories are going to come out because of some of these works, and I hope that we do very many others.
Okay.
You know, whether people campaign through them or not, you can't refuse them.
Tina, what do you think? Do you think it's going to instill patriotism?
Yes, it's going to instill patriotism. Just like he is saying, we have a generation of 32 down below. That is the biggest group of people we have, and most of us we only know the stories that trickled down, most of them watered down. So I think, yes, with him walking, with him telling us the reason as to why he's walking, given we are a type of people who is going to want to find out what is he talking about, You know, it helps us. We don't know so much of our history, but we're so quick to jump.
Okay.
You get what I'm saying? So yes, patriotism will be instilled. If I know the story as to why you're walking all those miles, I feel a part of something. I feel like, yes, you're going
to
have.
Me, I want to, you know, there's a Kasirye Gwanga walk. I would love to be a part
yes,
of.
So well.
Regarding one, conservation?
No. There's a one, there's a story of him, I think, walking away from Chitante to somewhere. It's when he had killed who. That story, you know, everyone tells it their own way. But what if we had Kasirye Gwanga walk and
walking
say,
and
tell
the story.
Tell the story. Actually, I think these walks, for me, what we don't see, Father To, it's like, you know, when your grandfather would come and he's like, Mbatebeze, Mbatebeze. That is what we should do.
Okay.
We keep calling him Jaja. He keeps calling us Ibazuku.
So literally.
Atutuza atubuli de katikuru na koluwaru no vesi jayari ankubi mpiso. Ngabante miyeko mgulu, netu kirida, katipatua kirida, netu sangani.
So literally the storytelling should move away from the fireplaces and this time around it should be within the walls.
Yes, that was what happened.
Tuwa nomule wali wa city square.
That would be interesting.
There you have it, of course, and we would like to say congratulations to everyone that managed that to be, of course, a part of the people that started this walk of 195 kilometers that did start on Saturday. And I want to get into some Saturday news coming in as far as the country is concerned. Now, our first starter headline, 70 treks, 195 kilometers. Now, details show that Ugandan President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni on Saturday began a six-day march through the jungle to retrace the route through which his guerrilla forces seized power 3 decades ago, which critics dismissed as a bid to rally support ahead of the 2021 general elections. Museveni is one of Africa's longest ruling leaders, having seized power in 1986 after taking part in rebellions to end the brutal rule of Idi Amin and Milton Obote, and is expected to seek a sixth term in office in the next election. He began what will be a 195 kilometer walk from Galamba, that is north of Kampala, and will end on January 10th in Birembo, south of the capital, where his rebel armed force faced one of its toughest battles in the fight to overthrow Obote. Those are some of, you know, the videos that we managed to get for you on ground as His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni was walking and, of course, meeting up with a couple of different citizens of the nation.
I mean, it doesn't matter if you agree with him politically or
not.
With him. He has a story to tell and lots of us could, you know, learn
could
from
benefit
story.
From it.
So I think that now is the time where, you know, we have young people, you know, regardless of what political divide you support, to just come and sit around
understand
and let this guy
history.
Tell us a story. After all, for me, I believe that the next president should actually be picking lessons from this guy.
Thank you.
If you're thinking of, you know, posing and no, you want to eat tear gas, it won't get you anywhere. This guy is not here for 3 terms, you know.
You know, NASA will take its
this
course
could probably,
at a certain point.
You know,
this could probably be his last term,
decade.
Is that what you're trying to say?
It could probably be his last decade.
Around.
So, yes, we are human.
All I'm going to say is, like Willis has put it, let us stop politicizing everything. For us to understand the politics of our nation, we need to understand the story of why our politics is the way it is. And these are the things that I feel will put us closer. It's just like when I read the mustard seed for the first time, I was like, oh, wait, snap. That detail was left out. When you watch 27 Guns, there were details that were left out. When you hear Kasirye Gwanga tell his story, there are details that are left out. So if I understand every vantage point of all these details from all these stories and we are walking the same walk where they happened, trust me, it gives me a sense of believing, a sense of belonging, and most importantly, I'll feel patriotic that there were people who wanted to see better for me. They took the harsh steps that I couldn't take or that my people couldn't take.
All right.
We have to appreciate it.
Anyway, there you have it, of course, for the latest what is coming in as far as His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni and his walk is concerned. I'm moving away from that. More news that is making headlines now. Apparently, over 500 turned up for UPDF recruitment in Kabale. Now, the Uganda People's Defense Forces nationwide recruitment exercise that commenced on December 27th last year, targeting over 4,000 personnel, is still underway until January 5th. That was yesterday. Now, the recruitment team is in Kabale or was in Kabale over the weekend, and over 500 people turned up at Kabale Municipal Stadium to join the forces. Now, according to the UPDF 2nd Division spokesperson, Major Charles Kabona, the exercise is free, but all participants must have the necessary requirements. He warned soldiers against extortion, saying anyone implicated will be subjected to the law. Kabona noted that only 64 recruits are needed from Kabale, but the turnout is overwhelming. The eligible recruits are senior 4 leavers, those with vocational and technical training, senior 6 leavers who need science combinations, and graduates of science courses. Now, recruits should be between the age of 18 to 25 without any health complications. For professionals, degree or diploma holders, a requirement in engineering, chemistry, and medicine is a priority. They should also be between 18 and 30 years of age. Professional science teachers and those of languages, that is French, Kiswahili, English, or even literature, are also allowed. The requirements include letters from the local council chairperson, 3 other chairpersons, district security office, and the original national ID. Recruits should be single without children. In April 2019, it was revealed that the Uganda People's Defense Forces, that is a UPDF, will recruit 3,000 soldiers in 2019-2020 financial year, according to the Defense Minister Adolf Mwesigye. The Defense Ministry requires an extra 80.4 billion Ugandan shillings to cater for salaries of the soldiers, as well as 10,000 local defense units that were recruited. Some of the insightful, of course, videos coming in from Kabale District.
You know why I'm laughing? I don't know if y'all got that clip that was going viral on and the guy was like, But I think people need to understand. You are not joining the Girl Scouts. You are joining the freaking People's
UPDF
Army. You know, it's armed forces. What? You expect them to be flicking you with a with a finger like, kambi situka, kale tujia kole encha. Well, who did you get on the chin to come? And how I know this how? I had a friend of mine, he was at university, and this is what we usually tell the youth. Don't sit back on your laurels, find something that you can do. So he looked for a job for 3 years.
And also, I would like to use this opportunity to call up the women. You know, this is also an exercise that we would like to see our, you know, beautiful, strong African Ugandan women partake. It would be a good thing to actually have overwhelming numbers of women that come through.
You saw me. You read your book such that when you're going to join the army,
for professionals, degree or diploma
holder.
Let's move away from that and, of course, talk about some sad news that are coming through as far as different police officers are concerned. Now, apparently, police officers stranded as fire guts Nebe police station residents. Now, details coming in show that fire gutted residents of police offices at Nebi Police Barracks in Nebi Municipality, destroying a property worth millions of shillings and government stores such as uniform and boots. According to Nicholas Nataja, that is the officer in charge of criminal investigations in Nebi, the fire started at around 2:30 a.m., leaving several police officers and their families homeless. The fire started in the room of an officer who was not around. By the time officers came to put it out, it was too late, Nanta just said. We did our best to stop the fire from spreading to other units, but we were too late. He added that the fire unit from Arua responded to prevent the police station and other parts of the barracks from catching fire. However, a police source said the fire unit arrived almost 2 hours after they were called due to the long distance. West Nile has only one police fire unit, which is stationed in Arua. It manages fire outbreaks in over 8 districts. We need a fire unit in Nebbi to prevent such scenarios. The guys arrived when more damage had already been done, the source continues to tell us. Nantaja said that the source or the cause of the fire has not yet been established, but the fire investigators are on ground to ascertain the cause of this fire. They did not rule out the possibility of an electric short circuit.
Oh, well, I mean...
It's true you need a fire unit, but what fire measures as individuals there have you put there? Do you have...
As the police itself?
Exactly. Do you have buckets of sand? Do you
Have you ever there? Walked into a Uganda police cell and found a fire extinguisher?
In the cell itself?
No. Mm. Actually,
at the station?
At the station itself.
Yeah,
apart from this one, the big ones,
there's a Metropolitan, there's Kira Road.
Thank you. Apart from the big ones, I mean the ones like Ogenze, Kula, and Biroku police station.
I think, but seriously,
still, let's think about it. Because, yes, this was a big police station. Mm-hmm. Let's face that. Mm-hmm. But the biggest police stations that we have, people never really access that quick, like the ones Ezibaliranye, Mukalo. Mm. And those police stations are always filled to the brim.
Yeah.
Mpapula bantu, muntu, mpapula bantu, kati yowe kwato omuliro. It's not just about the big stations.
Mm.
I think if we're going to do fire drills for the entire nation, police needs to get their own.
I think, you know, like one of those sources just said, we need to have, you know, more fire units, especially in the Western Nile part of the country. But it's very sad, and we'll leave it at that. But moving away from that, I want to take a quick look at some shout-outs coming through. Now, my shout-outs are going into the remnants, not these remnants of Zoe Grounds. No, you need to get it clear. These are remnant ministries who have marked 25 years. Now, apparently, for 25 years, Remnant Crew Ministries, one of the most popular Seventh Adventist musical groups, has lived by its motto of living to serve. On 1st January 2020, the group had a concert at the House of Rest Auditorium, formerly Fido Dido Auditorium on Kampala Road. The concert was about memories of the band's journey, achievements, and singing melodious and educative lyrics that have characterized their singing career. The original crew members include Pastor Prince Kalemera Mutebi, now head of the Luganda SDA Church, North London, UK. Hannington Bukenya Matovu, now director Nanziga, that is the SDA Primary School, Kiswele Wanguma, that is Radio Simba and Salt Media, and Rebecca Nalwada Chironde, who lives in North London. Those are the actual remnants that I'm talking about. I hope you don't get it twisted, but those are the people who mark 25 years.
Abby, I was about to just say, wait, the guy with the receding forehead has been here for 25 years and you know. Ha, damn.
But if you listen to SDA music, I think it's one of that very, I think they write the music codes.
Those are the guys.
Yeah, like there's the bass, there's a soprano, there's the alto, there's every bit.
And they usually have a capiano that's annoying.
So their choir is no joke.
They have
the bass guy looks like the bass is singing. Like,
Tina, take us through more shout outs before we run out of time.
Oh, Jesus. I even called Jesus' name out. I'd like to send shout outs to none other than Teddy Bujingo. Now, we all know 2019 was a very rough year for her, but anyway. Hundreds of Christians on Saturday turned up to launch a new church whose pastor is none other than Teddy Naluswa Bujingo, the estranged wife of Pastor Aloysius Bujingo. Now, early last year, the nation woke up to shocking news that Pastor Aloysius Bujingo of the House of Prayer Ministers in the city suburb of Obubuwayise had left his wife, Teddy Naluswa Bujingo, after 29 years in marriage, and moved on with one Susan Nantaba Namakula, aka Makula, way back in 2016. If you ask my sentiments towards this, what scope?
But why does Teddy look white instead of, you know?
The camera.
The camera.
The lighting.
So other people that were next to her, the camera was not what?
The lighting was on her. She was the movie.
No, you have to understand that she was standing with extremely light people. So the cameraman couldn't balance their light. To highlight.
So they balance.
It is like when me and you sit with a Mzungu in studio with.
Okay. Now people think that you've used gold powder. No.
No.
The camera is balanced to me.
Because you're the dark one on the show.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Let's move on.
No, but I think that
send shout out.
People ought to know that Banang. Business emwe gara no gula wenda.
Ochitagera no
see.
I like to shout out to Crested Crane Thieves and why? Because three people in Chisoro District have been arrested over illegal possession and trafficking of three Crested Cranes. Dan Idadukunda is a 22-year-old resident of Bunanga in Muramba sub-county. George Habiarimana is 25 from Gahiza in Buhozi Parish, Buza sub-country. And Hilary Tumushime is 28, a boda boda cyclist at Bunangana Stage in Bunangana Town. They were both where they were arrested on Thursday afternoon while trafficking three Crested Cranes into Democratic Republic of Congo. Samuel Amanya, the chief warden at Mugihinga National Park, says they have been receiving complaints of people trafficking Crested Cranes into the DRC. And Christopher Rukunde, Chisoro District Police Commander, says that the suspects are being held at Chisoro Police Station as investigations into the matter continue. While at the police station, Iradukunda and Habiarimana said they have been selling the Crested Cranes to a Congolese woman who only identified as Eva at 150K. However, Tumushime denied having knowledge about Crested Crane trafficking, saying that he was only hired by Iradukunda and Habiarimana to ride them into the border of Busanza. The Crested Cranes in Uganda is Uganda's national bird and appears on the country's national flag.
Wait, stop.
Yes.
I just had one question. Are they stealing them for tourism, or do they want to eat them, or are they just...
No.
What are they stealing them for?
The thieves steal them to sell them at 150K.
To get income, yes.
Yeah. What?
But
okay,
now we don't know
the
buyer.
Eva
buys them. Eva, from Congo.
You okay, yeah. What, what is Eva using them in Congo?
Eating them. I don't know.
We're going to go in for a very short break, but of course, when we do get back, we want to find out what is making headlines in the different dailies. It's a beautiful Monday morning down here in Kampala. And for those of you who are watching us from different parts of the country, we'd like to say good morning to you.